Hi students, today we can start exercise 11.1. In this exercise, mainly we will study direction cosine and direction ratios are related questions. Introduction of this exercise, that is exercise 11.1, in previous two videos we are completed. Now we can start. Question number 1. If a line makes angle 90 degree, 135 degree, 45 degree with x, y and z axis respectively, find its direction cosines. In here we have to find out a direction cosines already given some angles. You can see that figure. X axis, this y axis, Z axis. This is origin. One line passing through the origin. This thing, this is the line or line L. In here, in this question, they are given 90 degree angle makes with X axis and that line. This is X axis. That is our line. 90 degree. Then 135 degree angle with y axis. Okay. Then this is 135 degree. Then last 45 degree with z axis. From here we have to find out direction cosines. Direction cosines. First direction cosine is L equal to cos alpha. Equal to cos. In here alpha means angle between given line and x axis. That is known as angle alpha. How much that? That is 90 degree. Cos 90 degree. Cos 90 degree value is 0. Isn't it? Then second direction cosine is M equal to cos beta equal to cos. What is beta? Beta is angle between y axis and our given line, that is 135 degree equal to cos. This 135 degree we can write 180 minus 45. What is 180 minus 45? If you do 180 minus 45, 135 you will get, isn't it? This 135 I change as 180 minus 45 equal to 180 minus 45, we can write minus cos 45 equal to minus cos 45 is 1 by root 2. In lower class also we have studied cos 180 minus 45, otherwise pi minus 45, we can write minus cos 45, isn't it? Then last direction cosine is n equal to cos gamma. Cos, what is gamma? Gamma is angle between z axis and given line, that is 45 degree equal to cos 45 value is 1 by root. Now we got all the direction cosines, that is 0 minus 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2. Just pause the video, write down in your notebook. Now we can see question number 2. Find the direction cosines of a line which makes equal angles with the coordinate axis. Just look one figure. Y, X, origin, one line, I think this is L, one line given. According to our question, the line and all the axes will make equal angle. If you consider X and L, theta degree, that time Y and L also theta degree, third and L also theta degree, because already they are given the line which makes equal angle with the coordinate axis. With all the axes, the line makes equal angles. If I take in here theta, means all the angles will be theta only, isn't it? We can consider our angle is theta. Let line which makes equal angle be theta. As I consider theta is our required angle. Now we can write direction cosine. First direction cosine is L cos alpha. That is cos. What is alpha? Alpha means angle between x axis and line. That is theta. Cos theta. That M. M means cos beta. Beta means, what is beta? Angle between y axis and line. That also theta only. That cos theta. L equal to cos gamma. Gamma means angle between set axis and line. That also theta. Yeah, that cos theta. Already we have studied one relation, that is L square plus M square plus N square equal to 1. In relation of this exercise, we already studied this like one relation. Then L square means we can write cos square theta plus M square. That also cos square theta plus M square. Cos square theta equal to 1. Equal to 1, 2, 3. 3 cos square theta equal to 1. Then cos square theta equal to 1 by this 3 bring to right side. Cos theta equal to square bring to right side, that will be square root. Square root of 1, you can write 1 by 3 equal to square root of 1 will be 1 by root. When you take square root, we have to use plus or minus. Plus or minus 1 by root 3. This is our answer. Then, second, what is our question? We have to find out direction cosine. We can write, therefore, required direction cosine of a given line. What is first direction cosine? That is plus or minus 1 by root 3. Then again, plus or minus 1 by root 3 plus or minus 1 by root 3. Because in here already we got direction cosines are equal. Cos theta, cos theta, cos theta, isn't it? Cos theta already got it. That is plus or minus 1 by root 3. That is our answer. Question number 3. If a line has direction ratios minus 18, 12, minus 4, then what are its direction cosines? In here direction ratios given, we have to find out direction cosines. Given a direction ratios a direction ratios will represent by small letter A. A equal to first direction ratio is minus 18, then second direction ratio is 12, then C is minus 4. Direction ratio is given, then we can write direction cosines. Cosines of given line. How to find out direction cosine using by direction ratios? That also one formula I was studied. A divided by square root of A square plus B square plus C square. That this will be L. M equal to B divided by square root of A square plus B square plus C square. प्लस एन इक्वल टू सी डिवाइड बाय स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ ए स्क्वायर प्लस बी स्क्वायर प्लस सी स्क्वायर. दिस आर द डायरेक्शन कोसाइन्स. वी कैन गिव ऑल द वैल्यूज इन हियर. ए मीन्स माइनस 18 डिवाइड बाय स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ माइनस 18 होल स्क्वायर प्लस बी स्क्वायर इज 12 स्क्वायर सी स्क्वायर इज माइनस 4 equal to minus 18 divided by square root of minus 18 square will be 324. 18 square 18 into 18 plus 12 square is 144. 4 square is 16 equal to minus 18 divided by square root of, if you add this 324 144 16 and we'll get 4 in here, then 484 equal to minus 18 divided by 22. Square root of 484 will be 22. Then similarly we can find out m also. B is what is this, we can simplify, isn't it? We got it. What will get? Minus 9 by 11. Then next, m equal to b divided by b means 12 divided by square root of a square, same only. What will get in here? What we can write directly? We can write directly 22, isn't it? Equal to simplify 6 by 11. Then n c divided by this part. C means minus 4 divided by square root of a square plus b square plus c square. Already got it, that is 22, isn't it? 22 equal to minus 2 by 11. We got direction cosines. What are the direction cosines? Minus 9 by 11, 6 by 11, minus 2 by 11. Just pause the video, write down in your notebook. Now question number 4. Show that the points, three points given in here, we have to show that the three points are collinear. A given points are, this given name A is this point 2, 3, 4, B minus 1, minus 2, 1, C is 5, 8, 7. Three points given. First, we can find out a direction ratios of A and B. A direction ratio of A. How to find out? X2 minus X1, Y2 minus Y1, Z2 minus Z1. This is direction ratios. From here you can find out what is x1, y1, z1, x2, y2, z2. Because we are using a, b, a and b, c no need to consider now. And then x2 minus x1, that is minus 1, minus 2. Then y2 minus y1 is minus 2, in here minus 3. Then last 1 minus equal to minus 1 minus 2 is minus 3, minus 2 minus 3 is minus 5, 1 minus 4 is minus 3. This is our direction ratio of AB. Then again find out direction ratio of BC. Same formula we can use, x2 minus x1, y2 minus y1, Z2 minus equal to B and C. But then this will be X1, Y1, Z1. This will be X2, Y2, Z2. Find out from here, X2 minus X1 is 5 minus minus 1. Then 8 minus minus 2. Then 7 minus 1. Equal to, what you will get? 5 minus 1. 5 minus minus 1 will be 6. 5 plus 1. And here also 8 plus 2. 8 plus 2, 10. Then last 7 minus 1, 6. From here, we can take minus 2 outside. That time remaining minus 3 in here. In here remaining minus 5. Last part remaining minus 3. The direction ratio of AB and BC. How is that? Both proportional only. Check it, minus 3, minus 5, minus 3. In here also minus 3, minus 5, minus 3. We can take one common number outside. Therefore, here a direction ratios of AB and BC are proportional. The direction ratio of two lines are proportional means we can say that two lines are parallel. This line. Two lines are parallel. Then first line is AB, second line is BC. In here one problem is there. What is the problem means? B is only one point. When you draw these two parallel lines, they will be different two points. That's not possible, isn't it? We have only one B, then we have to draw one straight line. First A, here B, then C. AB and BC, that time that will be parallel. Then with one common point. But B is common. B is one common point only. So we can say given points are collinear. What do you mean by collinear points? Three points are collinear means when you join that three points, you will get one straight line. Then only we can say that three points are collinear, isn't it? Look at in here, we will get one straight line only. Then this points A, B, C are collinear points. Hence, proof. Just pause the video, write down in your notebook. Now question number 5. Find the direction cosines of the sides of the triangle whose vertices are 3, 5, minus 4, minus 1, 1, 2 and minus 5, minus 5, minus 2. The given one triangle, triangle ABC, first point is 3, 5, minus 4, second point is minus 1, 1, 2. Last point is minus 5, minus 5, minus 2. Vertices also given. We have to find out a direction cosine of each side. First we will find out direction cosine of AB, then we will find out direction cosine of BC, then finally we will find out direction cosine of AC. We can write the given vertices of triangle ABC are first vertex is 3, 5, minus 4. B is minus 1, 1, 2. Then C. Three vertices given. First, a direction cosine of side AB. Direction cosine of AB we can find out. That formula is x2 minus x1 divided by square root of x2 minus x1 square plus y2 minus y1 square plus z2 minus z1 square. Is L. In here, x2 minus x1, A and B only will consider, this is x1, y1, z1, x2, y2, z2. X2 minus x1 is minus 1, minus 3, divided by square root of this denominator we can write x2 minus x1 is minus 1 minus 3 square plus y2 minus y1 1 minus y square, then last 2 minus minus 4 square equal to minus 4 divided by square root of what I will get in here, minus 1 minus 3 minus 4 square will be 16 plus 1 minus 5 is minus 4 square is 16 again plus 2 minus and minus plus 4 6 square is 36 equal to minus 4 divided by 32 plus 36 68. Then minus 4 square root of 68, you can use in here factorization method. 68 use 2, 34 again use 2, 70. From here 1, 2 we can take out there. Minus 4 divided by 2 root 17. Got it? We will get answer minus 2 by root 17. This is first direction question. M means we can write y2 minus y1 divided by square root of same x2 minus x1 square plus y2 minus y1 square plus z2 minus z1 square equal to y2 minus y1. What is y2 in here? 1 minus 5. 1 minus 5 divided by this denominator. Directly we can write this 2 root 17 minus 4 by 2 root 17, got it? Minus 2 by root 17. The last n equal to z2 minus z1 divided by square root of same x2 minus x1 square plus y2 minus y1 square plus z2 minus z1 square. Z2 minus z1. Z2 in here, 2 minus minus 4. Okay. 2 minus minus 4 by 2 root 17. Directly we can write from here. We will get minus 6. 6 divided by 2 root 17 equal to 3 by root 17. Now we got a direction ratio of line AB is minus 2 by root 17, minus 2 by root 17 plus 3 by root 17. Pause the video, write down in our notebook direction cosine of AB. Similarly, we have to find out direction cosine of BC. You can find out BC, then again you have to find out direction cosine of AC also. Using the same method, we can do it that, just try it, that is homework for you.